young teacher, the subject of schoolgirl fantasy. She wants him so badly, knows what she wants to be. Inside her, there's longing, this girl's an open page. Bookmarking, she's so close now, this girl is half his age.
Hey diggers, Siren Kimmie here with Girls Rock Metal Detecting. Thanks for joining me for another relic-packed episode. I'm still smarting a little bit over the loss of that permission that was snaked out from underneath me. Poachers suck, that's all I'm gonna say. But I have other permissions, and there are more permissions to be gained, and there are tons of relics to be dug, so by God, we're gonna dig them. In this episode, we've got some awesome Civil War relics. We've got some coins and even an interesting find that I think you're gonna really enjoy. So sit back, relax, and join us on this adventure. Let's go check it out.
Got a really lovely flat button. Sadly, the shank is beat off of there. It broke off. Super fine strong. That is pretty neat. And it's brass, and my pinpointer's getting mad. Let me see what else I can find.
Found a pistol ball.
Not bad. And it was, oh bless, probably about 11 inches down there, if not farther, close to 12 inches. Madness. There's a truck over there. I lost Jerry in the woods somewhere. I think he's out in the woods. And I'm still digging this big field. Oh, there's Jerry over there. It's a big deal. And this is where I found the block eye. And I figure there's got to be other stuff out here. And I'm coming to find that it's probably really, really deep. So we're going to have to listen to those faint signals. Like this one was coming up as nothing. It was just a blip, a high tone. So that's what I'm going to start looking for.
I got this crazy thermometer. Does it say blood heat?
Intricate piece. I'm guessing it's a drawer pull. I think that's where the screw was, and that's where the little handle would have gone. Very cool. Got a gorgeous flat button. The shank's a little squashed, but yay! In a super trashy area, next to what I think is a dead possum in a cage. I'm a little freaked out about that. But I got a musket ball. Should I go set the possum free? I think it might just be playing dead. I don't want to lose the permission, so I guess I gotta leave it be. But I got that. Yes!
I think in that stainless steel, I'm trying to look at where it was broke off at.
I don't know, it looks silver to me.
I think it is, man.
Find the rest of it so we can get the mark off it. Jeremy's over there. He just found himself a carved gardener. A bullet?
The rings on the side?
Oh yeah. Yep, that's carved for sure. Yep, yep, yep. And you got another carved bullet.
Oh, really?
See? That one's carved like an acorn.
Oh, that's
an acorn. Carved. Yay, dude. We got possibly a silver knife handle from Jerry.
Let's just say it is, that's the only thing I found.
Gerald says that's the only thing I got, so we're going to say it's silver. I got the flat button here, the musket ball, there's an overall button, a little snap, some junk quarter, a reflector. And then we got Jeremy, he kicked some butt over here with the carved bullet, acorn, and then this is a gardener, and that looks like it was being carved too. And some, there's a tent grommet there, and a washer, and some coins. You said one's a wheat penny, right?
Yeah.
I'm too freezing.
All you can make out is one leaf on the back.
So that's our little roundup for this one.
Here's my Civil War.
Uh-oh, what you got? Oh, awesome. That was probably from the house, too. Was that in the field?
I don't remember. I found it was.
That's cool. There we go. We're freezing. It's 25 degrees out. We're done. We're out of here. And we got what looks like a spectacle buckle. Intricate little one. Shame it's broken. Very cool. That is a weird one. Is it a bodybuilder? Is it Arnold?
Into the chopper!
It looks like a bodybuilder to me.
It's weird button day. Red camel. Another rusted bag. Probably another overall button.
Very cool. Check it out.
We got ourselves a handgun. Good job, Jeremy.
Our secret honey hole.
Yep. Y'alls. Okay, we're back at it.
At first I thought this was a shotgun shell because that was filled in. I saw the little dots on the bottom.
Little holes. That is an old button.
It looks like it has some markings on it. Have to check it out when I get home and get it cleaned up, but nice. Jeremy got his gun and I got mine. It's all in pieces, but got another little buckle. That one's intact. It's got a little bit of leather on it. Pretty neat. Got a three ringer. Two. Now we're heading into the woods. Awesome. Looks to be a shot penny. Or somebody was trying to put a hole in it. But I can't make out what, whether it's a wheat penny or an Indian or modern. Says it's got a bullet. Let's see what you got. Oh, that's a Williams cleaner. A drop Williams cleaner. Awesome. Very cool.
It's fatter than the one you had earlier.
Alright. Jerry got one. Nice drop Williams.
Awesome.
Fisha.
Alright.
Cool.
Wheat penny.
A couple overall buttons. One says red camel. The other one looks like Arnold Schwarzenegger. I don't know what that's all about. Button back. This awesome spectacle buckle. Love that. And here's another little baby buckle. And a couple coins. And there is my gun, because Jeremy thinks he's all bad with that one over there, right? There's my gun. And Jerry got a Williams cleaner. I got the three ringer. Look, it was turning white in his pocket. Crazy. And check this out. This is the find of the day. That is, we're like 99% sure. I can kind of see. Yeah, there's writing on the back. You're gonna be able to see what that is. That's one of the Zouave buttons. The first Zouave regiment in the Civil War was the 9th New York Volunteer Infantry, also known as Hawkins Zouaves. They mustered on April 23, 1861. Other cities and states in the North and South also saw the creation of Zouave units. One French language newspaper commented, "It's raining Zouaves because there were so many units formed in 1861. There were Zouaves present at every major Civil War battle from First Manassas to Appomattox. Jeremy also got a suspender button and a cane tip and a percussion cap. And so that's the roundup, you guys. Right on the side of the road is the old lantern part. I don't know if there's any markings on there. I'll have to check that out.
I was not expecting this on this property. A musket ball. That is awesome. Very, very cool.
That's mean. Let's play money.
Check out this mangled up silver. It's a Washington quarter. And it is. It's a 1944. I'm trying to get the zoom in on it, but you can see the 44. It was pretty close to the surface, actually. Clearly it got run over, and it's really tarnished. But very cool.
Is it an old printer's plate?
It looks like an old printer's plate. Person, I can't tell, it looks like it's a man. I don't know, maybe it's an old lady. PL. I have no idea what product they were going to be selling, but it definitely looks like an old printer's plate. Very, very neat. We got a coin. Like a wheat penny. It's a 1930.
After the wheat penny. I was trying to get the date. I think it's 1888. That is an Indian. You can see the top of the headdress. And you can definitely tell by the back with the wreath. So 1888 Indian and 1930 wheat.
Quite a bit of stuff coming out of this property.
Really cool.
It's a bell and it's still got the ringer inside. Okay, got it cleaned up. Bell works and everything. This is just super cool, you guys. I have a lot of friends in law enforcement, so that makes it a little more special for me. We're on a main street, so I don't know, was it ceremonial? Maybe lost in a parade or an event? I don't know. It's bigger than a Gremlin motorcycle bell, so I don't think that's it. It's quite a bit bigger. I just don't know what it would be from. Maybe a horse harness? Oh, maybe it belongs to Sting. Maybe the police came through here on tour and it was on the bus and it came off, or... Nah. I don't know. I just love it. It's a really, really awesome find.
Hope you enjoyed the show. We've already been out there digging and we have a ton of great stuff lined up for the Memorial Day holiday. Some really appropriate items. So make sure you are subscribed so you don't miss that. Also, give a like, and if you're feeling perky, go ahead and share this video. I really appreciate the love. Thanks, guys. Take care and keep rocking metal detecting. Bye-bye.